is this?
Oh, you can see the perfectly in the shoulder.
Oh, you can taste it, mate, eh? Nice little tasty one. That's our one first kill. Was pretty happy about it. Now, it's probably important to remember that not to misconstrue that happiness and excitement with disrespect. It's natural to feel good. It's bred into us humans to feel good when we secure food, particularly amazing wild food like this. But we're going to pay ultimate respect to this animal by cleaning it up. We'll take the guts out here, and the whole lot's coming back with us to be eaten. Well, if you're a newbie or a tourist hunter like I am, it's pretty handy to have a guy like Russ around. Russ, he is going to show me how to take the guts out of the seeker hind here that we've just shot, and so we can get it back to the truck and into the meat safe. So take it away, Russ.
Righty-ho.
Step one.
Go and sit down, Bella. Right, so the first thing we want to do is cut that windpipe and the esophagus there as well. Just want to punch a couple holes in the Achilles. Helps if you've got a good sharp knife. So where people get a little bit stuck,
yeah,
is people will be too vicious with the cut and pop the grass back. Yeah. So if you can grab a handful of skin, yeah, you just run your knife along it.
Oh yeah.
And then two fingers. Oh, I did put a nick in there. Up. Down. So you want to roll it from the bottom first.
Yeah.
Then pull the grass bag out. And that'll expose the diaphragm in through here.
Yeah.
Basically you want to cut that diaphragm.
And that's sort of done more or less by feel, is it?
Yeah. 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 So in here you've got your heart, your lungs, your spleen, your liver on the bottom side. So basically you want to reach your hand in and grab all the pipes, pull the heart off, grab all those pipes because you've cut the throat. As you pull, everything will come out.
Yep, nice.
Oh, that's through the bullet. And then you can actually pull everything straight down.
Now you've left the
lung.
You've left the arse in at this stage.
Yep, so I will leave it in because you're going to carry it, Matt.
Oh, I thought, no, you were going to carry it, were you?
So that acts as a plug.
Yeah,
and it
stops
all the blood running down your arse.
Yeah, no, I've had that.
Yeah, so whip it head off.
Jeez, that's a good knife.
Get rid of that. We'll do these joints. So there's a top and a bottom.
Yeah.
You want to cut the bottom, but you don't want to go right around. So you want to do around the front and leave the back and give it a twist.
Yeah.
Like so. And you can, there's two ways you can do this. I'll do one like this. You put it behind the tendon and cut down against the bone.
Yeah.
And don't cut the tendon.
Uh-huh, I see.
And this way, you can do it differently.
Toggle.
So you've got the two joints, do the bottom one, break it, and now this way, you can go and cut down, but you're cutting towards yourself. Get out of it. So we'll drain it. Not much of that heart left.
Hit the heart, eh?
Blew it to bits.
Blew it to bits, that's what I was aiming for, mate.
Good gill. Be a tidy Kiwi.
Yeah.
Hide your grass bags and that. So now that's emptied. Get out of it. Get out of it. Go and sit in. So now we want to turn this into a pack. So there's the...
Yeah, there's your slots that you made
before
in the back.
We'll feed that through. Twist it,
toggle
lock
it off.
And the same on this side. Go and sit down. And there's your pack.
Beautiful.
All ready for you.
Backpacked. Yeah, okay.
Fair. Backpack.
Fair enough.
Well, my kind of backpack as well.
Yeah, it's a nice little one.
Yeah.
School bag. Heading off to school.
Oh, you got these nice little armrests here too.